Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a new makeup tutorial for you. This time I'm going to go for a sort of a wearable autumn glam look. Basically we're going to do dark eyeliner and lots of shimmer. But sort of in natural earthy tone, so it's still quite wearable I feel. And that's basically the best way I can describe it. So let's just hurry up and go put it on. Now, I've already actually done my eye primer this time around. I know, it's rare, but yeah. I don't know, it's just a repetitive step to like show every time. But this time I actually used just a primer without coverage. Because I want to do a wearable glam look this time around. Yeah, I know, that doesn't always turn out as planned, but we're going to try. And I'm going to use this palette for it, the Naked Ultraviolet, because I bought it because I really wanted it, and then I proceeded to toss it in a drawer and completely forget it ever existed. Oops. So yeah, long story short, we're going to use this today, or at least I'm going to use it. You can of course just use similar eyeshadow colors if you want. But yeah, anyway, I want warm nudes, I want some purples, I have really no idea what exactly I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna start somewhere and see where we end up. But as usual in such cases, I'm going to start off safely by just applying a transition... I don't know what word I wanted to use, a transition shade in the crease. Okay, that's that. Also, we've gone a step further in planning. Yes, really, because I was looking at this shade over here, VR, which is, I hope you can tell, a sort of warm burgundy-ish, brown-ish, purplish shade with green glitters in it. It's a very strange color, but I like it, so I want to use it. And I'm going to do what I also did in a Halloween tutorial, I think, last week. I'm just going to put a piece of plastic. This is just something that came on top of a blush to protect it. I keep everything. I don't toss things ever. Anyway, but I'm going to put it against my eye and then just blend the eyeshadow from there. So I hopefully get a nice crisp line without having to mess around with, like, you know, makeup removers and all. Okay, we're also a little bit closer now. This is basically what we're going to go for, except for the little indent here that's now on my skin. That's from a nail. I'm a brute. Anyway, what I always do is, you know, some people say aim for the tail of your eyebrow, but for me that means, because I overtweeze my eyebrows horribly, that the angle will be far too upwards for my liking, especially on this eye for some reason. Maybe I just, no, they're both equally short. Anyway, eyes are different. Point is, I always try to follow the line of my lower lash line upwards rather than to aim for the eyebrow, just because I feel like this is a better eye angle for me. Especially if I don't stab myself in the eye while doing it. So we have it like this and try to just get the plastic as snug against your eye as you can. And also while we're at the stage, try to look at yourself straight in the mirror and check if it's actually symmetrical. I think it is. I hope it is, but symmetry is really not something I'm good at, so I really don't know. But yeah, I'm just gonna assume that it's symmetrical. And then I'm going to go in with quite a dense brush. So this picks up a lot of product and that weird, hard to describe shade. And I'm just going to blend it inwards. Also, by the way, if you don't have a random piece of plastic from a makeup palette, you can also just, you know, use a business card or, I don't know, credit card, whatever. Obviously, if you're using a credit card, don't film it. Because, you know, privacy and all. Or post-it note, or, well, you know, whatever is, you know... Whatever is like bendable, has a nice edge to it, and is safe to put on your skin. That's basically it. But yeah, anything will do, and just keep blending this inwards. Okay, and because this shade is quite pale, I'm going to add the darkest shade of this palette, which is sort of a warm, dark brown. It's very pretty. Anyway, that's going to go on the outside of it. And I'm basically, I'm literally just stepping it on the plastic as well. Because I really want to get all the way to the edge there. And just packing this on, start blending it inwards. And this shade specifically, I really also want in the crease. And yes, we're having shimmer in the crease. I know some people don't like that. I personally don't really mind. Although I do think with all the shimmer going on with the eyes, I might actually keep my... symmetry and all. But I might actually keep my face really, really, really matte and do matte lips just to sort of counter all the overload of shimmer on my eyeballs. But yeah, I'm just making sure to blend this nicely, and then you can take off the piece of plastic or whatever you're using, check the mirror, and hope that it's symmetrical. It's decent, I'm surprised, but pleased. I might actually add an eyeliner, but I always do it at last because I want to use a liquid liner. And I know myself, I'm going to get the liner on the plastic and then I'm going to pull the plastic away. And then the liquid liner will smudge all the way to here. I know myself. But yeah, anyway, I'm just going to keep blending this for a little bit longer, just so it's nice and smooth. Then for the brow bone highlight, I'm going to use a shimmery nude shade. Because it's the most, you know, appropriate highlight in this palette. This below the eyebrow. Where else would I put the brow bone highlight? I don't know either. And then I'm going to blend it out just with my big fluff hair blender. No extra product on it, just to make sure that the top part there is already smooth as it can be. Because with that, the crease is pretty much done. And then for the eyelid, I'm going to use a really shimmery gold shade, just because I feel like it fits nicely with all the other shimmers. Yeah. And just because it also just looks like a very nice autumn shade to me. And I'm in a full-on autumn mood right now. Like, I've been working out in the rain for days. It also helps. Really, that's the part of autumn I actually least enjoy. But anyway, I've also already done a lot of autumn things. Like, I've made pumpkin soup. I love making pumpkin soup. I actually did a video on it a couple of years ago. Although I now actually use cinnamon in it. I actually shared it on my Insta stories, in case you've seen. In case the news that I made pumpkin soup wasn't news to you at all. And I also already went hiking in the forest. Although, admittedly, that was before the autumn colors even showed. I was planning on actually trying to go hiking in more autumn colored forests, but then it started raining and I'm not enthusiastic enough to actually go take a hike in the rain for fun. Like, at work as a postman, I get paid for it and that's something different. Like, but I don't want to just go out walking in the rain for no reason. But yeah, I'm planning on doing that once the weather gets better, because I just really love doing autumn things. Like, do you do autumn things? What autumn things do you enjoy doing? Like, let me know. Okay, anyway, both eyes are now relatively symmetrical. Now the next challenge is adding eyeliner and keeping it symmetrical. Wish me luck. And that's also done, surprisingly enough, even that became quite even. I'm surprised too. Anyway, I'm just going to quickly do my foundation off camera, because it's not very interesting, and then I'll come back to you. Okay, we're back. I did foundation also, for those of you who might remember from a video, I don't remember which one even. But, like, there was this foundation that was actually empty, which is actually my shade. And then instead of grabbing the new one, I put this empty thing back in my drawer for some reason. So long story short, my actual foundation in my shade is still in my stash behind my background screen. So I'm now darker in my face than on my body. Luckily I'm wearing a high neckline shirt. Because I had to make do with what I did actually have in my drawer. Anyway, that news aside, I've already done concealer on this eye, and as you can tell, it looks natural, but it does look a lot more awake and bright, and like, just, it looks a lot nicer, I feel, than this side. The way I accomplished it, I thought I'd show you because I sort of changed my routine again, is by just adding a very pale concealer, a very thin pale concealer, that's important, to the darkness in my inner corner. This is the Instant Awake Concealer by Catrice, which is really thin. So you won't get this uncomfortable, like, thickness underneath the eyes if you add something over top of it. Which is kind of nice. Especially if you want to put something over top of it. And then over top of that, I'm annoying myself. I hope I'm not annoying you. I'm going to use the Instant Age Eraser Multi-Use Concealer by Maybelline because it was on sale at my favorite drugstore when I was there like last week. Two for the price of one. So yeah, I bought it. And I did actually try it before. I don't remember. I think I stopped using it just because Catrice is cheaper. But this was cheap now. Not as cheap as Catrice, but I just couldn't resist, okay? I still like it. And this shade is normally my skin tone, but more yellow. Now it's actually a little bit paler than my foundation. Oops. But anyway, I'm just applying it below my eye. And I feel like this is just a very natural shade. Like, just grabbing some of her face and going alongside the wing here. But I just feel like this, to me, it just looks a lot more natural and a lot more flattering to my face than if I... Like, I always feel like if I use a very, very pale concealer, I like it sort of. But I never feel like it looks quite natural. And this is just, is it a little bit brightening, but it's, you know, subtle enough that it actually still looks like I just, you know, woke up like this rather than took a almost white concealer to my face. So yeah, blending it out. And we look nice and awake. Now we're gonna start on contour. I've already done this side. I hope you can see the difference. I will be usually using a very little amount of contour product because I don't want to make my face even darker because even my ears don't match anymore at this point. But anyway, I'm using a small brush for that purpose. I've also actually powdered my face before this. Maybe I should have started with that. I use a loose powder underneath my eyes just because I feel like it looks prettier, it looks softer. But I use the compact on the rest of my face simply because the compact is a lot cheaper. Yes, I'm actually a huge cheapskate. But yeah, it works well enough. But yeah. Anyway, I'm just, like I said, just keeping the contour quite soft because we're going for natural anyways. And like I said, I already made my face look 5 times as dark as it needs to be. I don't need to make it worse. Now I'm just filling in my waterlines with a burgundy-ish shade. I wanted something dark, but I didn't want full on black. I wanted some color, but I didn't want it to be too colorful, and this just seemed like the best idea at the time. Anyway, after I was done with the blush and the highlighter, by the way, I also obviously did my eyebrows. Because that just makes them look a lot more complete. And then to make the entire eye complete, I'm going to grab a tiny blending brush and I'm going to go into that weird shade and the really dark shade. And just tap in one, tap in the other, tap off the brush and then apply it in the outer corner at the bottom lid. I'm being careful with this because I want it to be there, but I don't want it to be really, really dark. Just want a bit of a shadow and then fading it out inwards. And then wiping off the brush and then just making a weird face so the skincare goes nice and tight. And then just blending so it all looks nice and smooth. Like so. And then I'm just gonna go in with a pencil brush in the very pale, slightly shimmery nude shade that I also use as a brow bone highlight. Because I feel like quite a subtle in a corner highlighter will just really, I don't know, look the best for this look. Then for lashes, I'm going to go for quite a natural pair because, well, for one, they're really easy to apply, which always helps. But also I feel like these just look very nice and, like, obviously they're not completely put on correctly now. But they just look really nice and, like, subtle and, you know, they don't take over the look, but they do, I feel, add something to it. And we have lashes. I'm just filling in, covering up my bottom lashes. I'm applying mascara to my bottom lashes. Let's just not try to sound original here. I'm using a mascara that's pretty much empty, so I'm guaranteed to have no clumps, because there's not enough product left in the entire thing to create clumps. I'm also using that to push my own top lashes towards the falsies. So they merge nicely, and then I'm just going to put on a matte nude lipstick and we're done. And we're left with the final results. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my tutorials and other random videos, you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel. As far as all the products I've used go, you can find everything, names at least, below in the video description. And as always, like, you know, you don't need to use the... I always feel like I should mention this, because, really, I don't want to, like... Like, I want to motivate people to try out makeup. I don't want to make people feel like they can't do a certain thing if they don't have a certain makeup product. That's why I don't really mention a lot of products. But, you know, just for full disclosure, everything is listed below the video. But if you want to do this look as well, you can just use whatever stuff you have, whatever products you have, whatever brands you have. Just follow the steps and you probably will end up with something similar. So, yeah. Other than that was it for today, so thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!